for something truly extraordinary, don't you think? This one's a real treat.
It's you. Good evening. You have come just as promised. You may forego the formalities, but you may simply address me by using my surname, Neuvillette. I'm a little more familiar with you now. I can match your movements. So this is what you're truly capable of? And I shall have to get serious if I wish to catch up with you. It's quite all right. I can sense your joy. It is indeed a delightful moment. By proper etiquette, I would be perfectly happy to chat with you if that is what you would like. My apologies. I was just caught off guard by the absurdity of the situation. So you have heard of that local legend as well? Who told you about that? Or more pertinently, who was responsible for spreading it in the first place? Well, never mind. I don't think that the Hydro Dragon would weep. Per se, I think he just finds himself a little stirred when he gets a taste of the tears that have been shed on this land, on account of all of the emotions they contain. This is truly wonderful. I think things are exciting enough in here as it is. I hope you have not encountered any unpleasantness today. I see. Then is there something that I can help you with?
suppose.
Apparently, I'll have to show a little more of my true capabilities. Let me see what I can do. Please do not worry. The pleasure is all mine. Simply, I am the Chief Justice, or Eudex, of Fontaine. I accepted this position because I wanted to seek out answers to questions that have perplexed me. But the one question that puzzles me the most concerns my own existence. In essence, I neither know why I was born in this form, nor do I understand where my long life should take me. I lost many memories from the moment I was born. The primordial sea, for example. I can only vaguely recall its connection to me, but I am unaware of what that connection is exactly. I sincerely hope you'll be able to keep this a secret for me. Observing the starry sky from the bottom of a deep lake. It is by no means intentional, and I also know it is not something that I can easily make up for. Unlike water, emotion does not settle quickly once agitated, nor is it naturally inclined towards equilibrium.
Je m'abandonne et je m'envole, vole, vole.
I have been holding on to these unanswered questions for a long time. But there is one thing I've discovered along the way. My emotions easily resonate with those of others. Even I don't have the slightest idea what they mean. My guess would be that there are at least some similarities between humans and myself. By observing their behavior, perhaps I could one day understand the meaning of my existence. But I find such progress difficult to describe. As an outsider, chances to engage in meaningful interactions with others are few and far between. That's why I'm quite thankful for this chat. Such opportunities are rare. Self-expression is not one of my strong suits. Pay it no heed, it's nothing. Merely a consequence of my identity and personality. Do not worry about me. To appreciate magic, you should focus on the show happening on stage, rather than getting caught up in trying to see that which has been intentionally hidden. Just enjoy the show. scenery here is pleasant. It makes one feel happy. But I've been meaning to ask, are you all right? Please pardon my lack of consideration. Take a break if you are tired. Of course. Please, go ahead. To be quite honest, I am not sure what we should do. Would you like to have some drinks, perhaps?
Wow. When I heard that you were friends of Monsieur Neuvillette, let's spice it up a bit.
Ridesley.
See, everyone keeps asking this question. Are you too sure you're not a couple and just using your work as a convenient cover? I win this bet. You owe me a present.
Very well. It was indeed just as you said.
You made a bet? So what gift must the loser give? Tea?
He already has tons of tea in his office. I'm thinking about a set of legal codices.
That wouldn't happen to be a dig at my lack of legal awareness, would it?
Well, I'm sure His Grace doesn't consider the fortress to be outside the law.
I was under the impression the residents of a place like this would be uninterested in the legal codices.
That was obviously a joke.
Oh, apologies. I took your question in earnest, but it now occurs to me that it was most likely in jest. Now then, if you'll excuse me, no need to see us off.
Why not stay for a cup of tea?
Thank you for the offer, but I should get going. Ridesley is a trustworthy man. I fought hard for the title and reputation he now has. I expect you to think that I've simply been duped by his flattery and appearance of loyalty, but to that, I would quote the Inazuman proverb, "The words unspoken are the flower," which means some things are best left unsaid. There's nothing to hide. I was simply organizing my thoughts. Perhaps we should go. There shouldn't be too many people near the Fountain of Lucene during the evening. My apologies. This heavy rain must be quite an inconvenience for you. However, there's hardly anyone around. Looks like we got lucky today. I've been turning a question over and over in my head. Just what is justice, anyway? There was once a time when I didn't want to believe that there could be anything more important to humans than life itself. Oh, rather than that, it's probably more truthful to say I didn't believe humans were capable of resisting the most basic instinct of living things. That they could rebel against their own nature, or consider certain things to be more important than their own lives. And in the end, from a certain perspective, cannot fully understand myself. I should have noticed all of this much sooner. How should I describe it? Surprise, relief, fear, and regret. As I said, I find it difficult to express my emotions because I cannot fully understand myself. But this blend of emotions has led me to finally understand some things. I would like to hear your thoughts, too. What do you think of me? Since some time ago, I have begun to notice the changes that have occurred upon my person. These changes were not due to any specific occurrence, but emerged as a result of time itself. I will try to contemplate this further. Despite my social status, I am still an outsider. From my perspective, I have simply been fulfilling my duties. It isn't anything special or worthy of praise. I'm simply fulfilling the promises I've made and searching for answers through my judgments. It is unnecessary to hold me in such high regard. The complexity of human emotions and willpower far exceed those of mine. As a matter of fact, I believe that you are the ones who deserve my respect. Logically speaking, both time and effort are essential when different species attempt to peacefully coexist. It will be a difficult road ahead, with countless obstacles to overcome. Different identities and ways of thinking all contribute to strengthening the barrier between one another. Removing it will be no easy feat. There aren't many suggestions I can share. All manner of miracles are possible if you are only willing to believe.
Puisque sans toi, plus rien ne rime, plus rien ne rime, rime, et je m'abîme, bîme, et je m'abîme, bîme. Je suis allé au bout du monde, j'ai demandé pardon, je suis là et je t'attends. Sous les étoiles d'Orion, il y avait comme un son perdu dans l'univers. Est-ce que ce serait toi? Oh, comme je l'espère. Je suis là où tu m'as laissé, sur la route du néant. Ici la lune n'éclaire jamais, elle jaunit avec le temps. tu laissais prendre l'otage, puisque sans toi, plus rien ne rime, plus rien ne rime, rime, et je m'abîme, bime, et je m'abîme, bime. Tu m'attendais, mais le temps paraît lent. Je ne peux m'empêcher de penser comme une enfant. Que veux-tu que j'y fasse? Rien n'est plus enivrant que de s'accrocher à toi et d'y croire tout le temps. Je suis là où tu m'as laissé, sur la route, sur ce banc. Ici la lune n'éclaire jamais, elle jaunit avec le temps. Et de nuage en nuage, sur les ailes d'un oiseau blanc, je me suis laissé prendre en otage, puisque sans toi, plus rien n'arrive. Plus rien ne rime, rime, et je m'abîme, bime, et je m'abîme, bime.
Are you leaving now? I see, I see. All right, it's about all the time that we have to talk privately. It will soon be time for me to leave this blissful tranquility behind and return to Palais Memoria. It was my honor to provide you with what answers I could. I very much enjoyed conversing with you. Night. I am quite fond of the image of a perfectly still body of water, and it is on this note that I would like to wish you a peaceful, undisturbed sleep. May no waves of emotional distress ripple through your dreams tonight. See you next time.